Hello and welcome to another segment with the Nairobi Hospital. Today we're joined by Joyce Mbetha, Acting Principal at the Cicely Macdonald College of Health Sciences. Karibu sana.
Thank you, Mahana.
So I'd like you to tell us more about the College of Health Sciences.
Okay, Thank you. The college was first established in 1956. The hospital was established in 1954. This was followed by the college being established when it was realized that we needed nurses who were trained. And so it was first established, and most of the students then were from white population. And then we had a few Africans then. But this went on until 1992, when we had our first, 94, when we had the first male students. And 2005, we had first post-basic training. I'll talk about that later. All this time, we were known as Cicely Macdonald School of Nursing. But then the name changed in 2015 to College of Health Sciences.
So what are some of the qualifications one needs to join the college?
This depends on which program you're pursuing. Our program is regulated by the Nursing Council of Kenya. Mm-hmm. And so they give us the qualifications and the criteria that one needs. So a student needs to have done their KCSE and scored at least a C. Biology is the center of it, so you must have scored a C in biology. English, it must be a C. And one other science subject, could be maths, could be chemistry. Could be physics, at least you must have gotten a C minus, but that is for the basic. Mm-hmm. Then we have the post basic. You need to have be a Kenya registered nurse, or you need to have, or to be a Kenya registered community health nurse, or you need to have to be a bachelor, to have gotten your bachelor's or bachelor of science in nursing. And so you need to have trained, to have worked for at least a year or two. These are council requirements, so that now you qualify to come and join our post-basic courses. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What is your current student population?
Currently, we have a total of 287. Of this number, 186. The Kenya registered nursing students, the basic, and then the rest, I think it's 77, are the post-basic students. And one thing that I'd like to mention at this point, that we get our students not just from within our borders, we also get our students from outside our borders. Mm-hmm. We have students from within the East African region. We've just had a group qualify from Tanzania. We also have students from Rwanda. We also have students currently from West Africa, particularly Nigeria. We also have students from South Africa.
You also have scholarships that you do offer to the students. Mm-hmm. How does one get to access or benefit from it?
Okay. Now, what happens is that we partner with organizations that we approach. Mm-hmm. For instance, we have what we call the LEAP program. LEAP program means Lending for Education, the East African Partnerships. It is a program, it's a fund that is accessible to our students, where they can get loans, student loans, which now they'll pay back. We also have Johnson & Johnson through AMREF Africa that support our one of our post-basic studies. We've had help in the past, but now we are doing a proposal so that they can come in a bigger way to support our students. Mm. Yeah.
With the onset of COVID-19, so many things changed, and one of them is your teaching modalities.
Yes.
So what are some of the programs or other aspects that you have picked up in ensuring continuity in learning?
Okay. Thank you. Now, one of the things that I probably want to mention at this point, that during the peak of the COVID-19 last year, we were among the few colleges that did actually admit students in September. You remember September, things were still not okay. We adopted the virtual mode of teaching the students until when we were now allowed to for students to come to college. It was around January. They did come now to be taught physically, especially for theory. We are able to do both online and physical, but when it comes to clinical practice in the clinical area, then we had to wait until things had abated a little. Then now they were able to go to the clinical areas. Mm-hmm. Yes.
What are some of the facilities available at this College of Health Science?
Other than what we have within the environs of the college, which includes our very good and very state-of-the-art library, we have very spacious and large lecture theatres. We have a very good auditorium that we also use for our studies. And this also, one of the things it does is that we are able to observe the Ministry of Health WHO program in terms of the COVID prevention program. We are able to social distance very, very well. Mm-hmm. But that is within the college. Mm-hmm. Then for clinical practice, we are using our own hospital for most of it. So most of our students, they get their training, both basic and post-basic in our hospital. Mm. We also, we partner with institutions like Kenyatta, where our students go for specialized training, a clinical practice. We also partner with institutions like Mathare, Teaching and Referral Hospital, that is a mental and psychiatric hospital. We also work with the Nairobi Metropolitan Services, where we take our students to their clinics. So right now, we're working towards developing an MOU with the Kenyatta University, a teaching and referral hospital, where we can also send our students to. Mm-hmm. Yes.
When is the next intake?
We do have two intakes a year. So we've just had one. We just had our last one in April, where we got a number of students. So the next intake will be in September. And currently, applications are ongoing, and we are hoping to do, we are shortlisting, and we're hoping to do our interviews in July. Yeah. So our next intake will be in September.
On the application bit, eh?
Yes.
Do you do it virtually or you come physically to the hospital to do your applications?
We have the walk-in who have not gone to our websites and seen that we can actually apply online. But most of the time we advise that when somebody calls, and there are those who send their emails and they communicate, I tell them to go to our website, read about our requirements. If they meet our requirements, then we have our application forms, then they can go ahead and apply. Mm. But then we also have those ones who walk in, and we also give them that service. Mm. So we do both. Mm. Yeah. Probably just to mention that as a college, as an institution, if you look at our brochures and you look at our advert, we say that the employability of our graduates is about 99%. And this is true. Because once they graduate, we not only absorb them ourselves, but they are taken up immediately by the other institutions around us. Mm-hmm. And one of the reasons why one would ask, why are you always having those vacancies? It's because they work for 2-3 years and they're taken, or they go elsewhere, mm-hmm. because we believe they're that good. And so once they graduate, like the ones who are going to graduate soon, they will all be absorbed within the hospital. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Applications are ongoing for the September intake until the 12th of July. For more details, visit the Nairobi Hospital website. I've been your host, Modoni Wawero.